Instead of holding a session at the Batasan Pambansa, lawmakers seeking to oust House Speaker Allan Peter Cayetano trooped to the Celebrity Sports Plaza Monday for a plenary session. After more than a month of power struggle, 186 congressmen declared a speakership vacant and elected Marinduque Representative Lord Allan Velasco as the country's fourth highest leader. It came after House lawmakers signed a manifesto backing Velasco and the term-sharing agreement, which President Duterte brokered last year between the two House rivals. The proceedings also took place a day before Congress convenes for a special session to resume budget deliberations. In his inaugural speech, Velasco recalled how difficult their climb to the top was while assuring the public of the timely and constitutional passage of the 2021 budget.
Whether famine or feast, poverty or plenty, a leader will always rise to the challenge. It has been a difficult journey to get to where we are, one fraught with many frustrations and complications. But then, we are all here.
Citing their support, Velasco also thanked President Duterte and his children. Mayor Sara Duterte earlier said her regional party, Hugpong ng Pagbabago, will respect the term-sharing pact after Velasco paid her a visit last Friday. Congressman Paulo Duterte, meanwhile, has distanced himself from the speakership row even after meeting Cayetano in Davao 2 weeks ago. Velasco urged Cayetano to ensure an orderly transfer of power in the lower chamber. Velasco also offered a so-called healing hand to Cayetano as he says he is willing to appoint him as deputy speaker to move forward.
I would like to extend my hand to Speaker Cayetano and hope that he would be amenable to sit down with me as we comply with the term-sharing agreement.
But Cayetano is not stepping down just yet. He calls Monday's proceedings a travesty. He says his colleagues should focus first on the passage of the 2021 budget.
I am here for one thing, to finish this, no? And to leave the House a little bit better than when I got here. But if you are a Congressman Velasco bent on destroying everything, burning up down the House, I can leave here anytime, but I will not allow you to burn this House down.
Cayetano also believes he has the numbers to stay as Speaker.
205 yung nakapirma sa akin. Okay? So kung 186 sila, ang problema ko may flying voters na 80 o dalawa yung binoto. So pag dalawa binoto, under the rule, tanggal yung boto nila. But that's not the rule. The rule is the voting has to be in the session hall.
Monday's proceedings have ignited legal questions. Before the session, the House Sergeant at Arms said the mace displayed at a sports club in Quezon City is not official. Deputy Speaker Neptali Gonzalez II adds no resolution authorized Monday's proceedings outside Batasan Pambansa. But Congressman Rufus Rodriguez defends the legality of Monday's session.
There is absolutely nothing in the Constitution or in the House of Representatives or in any Supreme Court ruling which declares or rules directly, indirectly, or by inference that any session of the House of Congress and all matters taken thereat are invalid or null and void in the absence of the mace.
As for Malacanang, President Duterte is still keeping his hands off the House speakership issue.
Wala na po siyang pakialam kung anong gagawin ng mga mambabatas matapos maipasa ang 2021 budget. To each his own. Wala pong pinapanigan, may the best man win for the speakership.
RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.